जय जिनेन्द्र एवरीवन। अहिंसा का डंका बजाया था महावीर ने, धर्म पर बलिदान हटाया था महावीर ने, अज्ञान अंधकार मिटाया था महावीर ने, जियो और जीने दो सिखाया था महावीर ने। हैप्पी महावीर जयंती टू एवरीवन। प्रभु वर्धमान जिनवर सिद्धार्थ फूल चंदन, त्रिलोक पूजनीय है मातृशिला के नंदन, अलोकित है नवदारा दिव्य प्रकाश से, परपित महावीरा को करे शत शत वंदन। टुडे फ्रॉम द पाचला बैचेस वी डोंट हैव छोटे विरागी, नन्हे श्रावक, वीर शासन और पद्य कदम। इंस्टेड वी हैव ऑल फोर बैचेस परफॉर्मिंग टुगेदर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम। वी हैव मोर देन 50 पीपल परफॉर्मिंग इन वन स्किट। Please try to maintain silence and follow the various scenes. We have humor, dance, and soul-touching moments planned in this skit to celebrate a very special day for a very special Bhagwan. What a better way to celebrate a Bhagwan Mahavira's last bow. Bhagwan Mahavir was the last and 24th Tirthankar of the Jain faith. We will present today inspiring stories of how baby Vardhaman lived through childhood and attained other names, Veer, Mahavir, Sanmati, and Ativir. As most of you know, Sri Mahavir took Muni Diksha at 30 and meditated for the next 12 years before he attained Keval Gyan. Dad, you are 42. In case you forgot and were wondering where you should be in life, here's some benchmark for you to look forward to. So, without further ado, let me request the start of the Mangalacharan.
जो मोह माया मान मत्सर मगन मरण वीर है, जो विपल विघ्नो बीच में भी ज्ञान धारण धीर है, जो धरण तारण भव निवारण भव जल के तीर है, वे वंदनेशी जिनेश तीर्थंकर स्वयं महावीर है। जय जिनेन्द्र।
Happy birthday, happy birthday. Hope you had a lovely day.
Thank you. Yeah, my day was great. Was awake from midnight celebrating. Lots of cake, food, movies and chill. Bought new video game Fortnite. Was up all night playing it.
Really? Is that how you celebrated your birthday?
You do remember you're a Jain, right? So how did you stay up late and play violent video games?
Oh, I didn't know staying up late on your birthday was a crime.
You're still a bit too young, aren't you? Staying up late is not a crime, but not going to the mandir, not doing puja,
studying religious scriptures, paying some attention to your soul, questioning whether you're 1 year older or 1 year closer to your next birth.
Where do you want to be? End up playing violent video games and become a Tiryansh? Or aim to be like Lord Bhagwan Mahavir and by focusing on our soul?
Fortune has it, today is Bhagwan Mahavir's birthday. You surely could do better.
Bhagwan Mahavir's birthday?
Okay, today Vardhaman was born for one last time, approximately 2,550 years ago, became Lord Mahavir.
Gotcha. Please tell me more about Bhagwan Mahavir.
Why tell? Let us take you to 599 BC, where King Siddhartha and Queen Trishla are having a chat.
My dear Queen, you look perplexed. What is bothering you?
Dear King, I had a dream last night, very unique and very auspicious looking, but I don't know what it meant.
Not to worry. Tell me, what did you dream?
I had 16 different dreams.
Oh, please elaborate your 16 different dreams.
Oh, Wow, that was incredible. 16 wonderful dreams.
Siddhartha summoned the scholars of the court and asked them to explain the meaning of the dreams. According to the scholars, the dreams meant that the child will be born strong, courageous, and full of virtue.
On Chaitra Sutteras in Vaishali Kundgram, Balak Vardhaman was born. As soon as the Bhagwan was born, a cool breeze was blowing all around the wood. Flowers were showered from the heaven.
Horns were blowing. There was an attractive sound of shank. All the Devlok were celebrating the birth festival.
Okay, tell me more about baby Vardhaman. Did you go private schooling or nursery?
Oh no, you're not getting any smarter this year. Why don't we take you back 2,500 years back where Vardhaman was playing with his friends?
Oh my god, there's an anaconda snake here.
Run for your life, fellas. Run to the mountain. Don't worry, I will sort it out.
Alright, let's go and press the snake.
Has he taken a snake vaccine or what?
What if the snake bites him? You are the bravest. You are the bravest of brave. How did you do that? You are the bravest of brave.
You are so brave. You are so brave. How did you do that?
You're Mahavir, strongest of all, Mahavir.
Ready the snake, girl.
Oh, Lord. You are Veer as well as Mahavir. Your immense strength is discussed even at Devlok. Even being a Dev, my limited knowledge brought me here to test your bravery. You are Veed as well as Mahavir.
Vini Mahan Vita, Eko Bahar enemy Same Vapar Vamatenati, Eto under Naka Shai Rupi enemy ne Jeetwani Vitragi Vitache. Vini Vitrakta na Sanidhyama, poisonous snake pun a hinsak bani jache.
Oh no, look at that elephant. He is destroying anything that is coming in his way.
The villagers are terrified for their lives. The elephant is destroying their houses.
Don't worry, I will sort it out.
Wait, the crazy animal will hurt you and may kill you.
Has one man taken the elephant's vaccine as well?
Don't worry. Stay calm. Stay here. Oh, Gajraj, come out to this madness. People don't know why they're running wild, but I do. You're tired of these four gutties. Especially the pain of tedience is causing you severe misery and impatience. I would humbly advise you to stay calm and carry on.
Dear Prince, your serene nature has calmed me down and hereforth will aim to stay calm and civil for the rest of my life.
Mahavir bahar na koi balti ki weapon di nahi pan atma ni shanti shanti na balti hati ne bashma kare le do evi rete koi nuclear weapon karta shanti nu bal soti mahan che ek chetan bav pan mota mota hati jeva karam Karam, Uday, Nadey Bab, Jite Leche.
One name given by his parents, second name given by Indra, third name given by Dev, fourth Sanmati.
Oh wow, seems that your doubts have already started to clear up just by hearing Mahavir Puran.
It had to, right? Just like how Munishi, Sanjay and Vijay got their doubts cleared.
How did they attend the online course from Baby Vardham?
No, they did not attend any course. Let me take you back. More than 2,600 years ago, when it was the Dangar Pashranath era.
When Vardhaman was a baby or toddler, two, Muniraj, Vijay and Sanjay were travelling through Summit Shikharji. In their sadhana, they had a doubt that they thought wouldn't be cleared unless they spoke to a Kevali Bhagwan.
How could they get it resolved? Lord Pashranath was in Moksh and Vardhaman was a baby playing in his mother's lap.
Indeed, it was a tricky situation. However, when two Muniraj were passing by the Raj Mahal, they happened to see baby Vardhaman.
Suddenly, they felt amazed. Their Mati Gyan started to take clarity all over their doubts.
Pleased by the outcome, they were honored to give the name Samatinath to Lord Mahavir.
Muniraj Prabhu ne Samatinath Visheshan ti alankrit karya. नगर जनों में प्रसन्नतेने उत्सव करियो, देवे आकाश में वाजा वगारिया, आनंद व्यक्त करियो, अहो सन्मतिनाथ, आप हमने अपूर्व सम्यक मति ने दातार छो, अने आपने उत्कान वरे अमारी मति सम्यक थे छे, ने तेना वसी चैतन्य तत्व ने पामी ने, अमे आपना मार्ग ने सारी रेया छे,
बोलो सन्मति देने वाले सन्मति नाथ की जय हो।
How was boy Vardhaman? Must be very smart with his friends and all the knowledge. Surely he would have cracked GCSE and A-levels and invited at Oxford University.
No, you need to see how he explained the theory of relativity way before Einstein did.
One day, Vardhaman was sitting on the second floor of his palace, deeply engrossed in contemplation. His friends came looking for Vardhaman, but found Vardhaman on the first floor.
Where is Vardhaman?
Look upstairs.
Where is Vardhaman?
Look downstairs.
We searched every floor and you are hiding on the second floor.
Why didn't you ask my mother or father where I was?
Your mother said you were upstairs while your father said you were downstairs. Who was right?
They both were. For my mother, I was upstairs as she was on the first floor. And for my father, I was downstairs as he was on the fifth floor.
Vardhaman then explained how items in the world can be described differently depending on the angle you look at. This is called relativity. Vardhaman often explained real-life situations to explain deep religious meanings.
Wow, the theory of relativity explained with such simplicity thousands of years before Einstein did.
Not only theory of relativity, a number of other theories, like plants are living beings, is also mentioned in our Shastras for thousands of years. Way before Nobel Prizes were awarded to Jagdish Chandra Bose, only 115 years ago.
That's another very important point about non-violence to all. Way before today, veganism started becoming a multi-billion dollar industry.
I am truly amazed. Did Sanmati ji have a career in physics and have his own family?
Lord's knowledge was way above physics that we know. It encompassed the three laws, past, present and future of every living being.
So Trishla Mata never persuaded Sanmati ji to get married. My parents already on my older brother's case and are saying, Settle the job, handle the chair, which means it's time to get married.
Let's see how Mata Trishla tried to get him married.
One day from the Champapuri province of the Kaleng state, Emperor Jitshatru sent a messenger along with numerous gifts. He requested that our Princess Yashoda is multi-talented, extremely beautiful and spiritually conscious and values-driven young lady. Having learnt about Prince Veer, our Emperor has proposed a marriage made in heaven between Princess Yashoda and Prince Veer.
Beta, main samajh sakti hu ki tum lakho bhavya jeevo ka udhar karke मुक्ति सुंदरी का वरण करना चाहते हो, ये तो उचित है, उत्तम है, पर एक माँ का हृदय पुकारता है और कहता है कि अभी तुम्हारी युवा अवस्था है, इसलिए विवाह करके गृहस्थ आश्रम चलाओ। तुमसे पूर्व ऋषभादि तीर्थंकरों ने भी ऐसा ही किया है। मैं चाहती हूँ कि तुम ये रिश्ते के लिए सोचो और हाँ कह दो।
माँ, तुम जानकर भी पुत्र मोह के कारण ऐसा कह रही हो, क्या तुम संसार के जाल को नहीं जानती? देखो तो सही, कितना दुखी है ये विषयाधीन संसार, इससे तो जितना जल्दी छूटा जा सके उतना अच्छा। हे माता, मेरे लिए ऋषभादि तीर्थंकरों का उदाहरण उचित नहीं है, क्योंकि उन तीर्थंकरों की आयु तो करोड़ों अरबों वर्षों की अति दीर्घ थी, लेकिन मेरी आयु तो सिर्फ 72 साल की है, उसमें से 30 साल व्यतीत हो चुके। मेरे लिए तो अंतिम तीर्थंकर श्री नेमिनाथ और श्री पार्श्वनाथ का उदाहरण उचित लगता है। उन तीर्थंकरों ने भी विवाह नहीं किया था, उसी प्रकार मैं भी आत्मा को विवाह के बंधन में नहीं बांधना चाहता।
वीर कुमार, तुम्हारे उत्तम गुणों को देखकर मुझे बड़ा आनंद आता है। आहा, एक तीर्थंकर की मौसी होने के नाते मेरा हृदय गौरव का अनुभव करता है। परंतु प्रिय वीर कुमार, मैं मात्र तुम्हारी मौसी होकर नहीं रहूंगी। जब तुम तीर्थंकर होगे और जगत को मोक्ष मार्ग का उपदेश दोगे, तब मैं भी तुम्हारे मार्ग का अनुसरण करके तुम्हारे शासन को सुशोभित करूंगी।
हाँ मौसी, तुम्हारी बात सच है और तुम्हारे उत्तम धर्म संस्कारों को मैं जानता हूं। तुम भी संसार के जाल में नहीं फंसना चाहती और आत्म साधना में जीवन बिताना चाहते हो, यह जानकर मुझे आनंद हुआ।
बस पुत्र की हृदय को बराबर जानने वाली माता ने फिर कोई विशेष तर्क नहीं किया। पुत्र की महानता देखकर वे मन ही मन गौरव का अनुभव करने लगी। उनके मोह पर मानो महावीर के वैराग्य का कुठाराघात होने से मोह के टुकड़े होने लगे। धर्म साधना के प्रति उनका चित्त दृढ़ हो गया।
I'm truly mesmerized with what I've learned today, and also realized how one should celebrate their birthday in the right way. Lord Mahavir's birthday is truly special given. It was celebrated to mark his last birth in the cycle of birth and death, which we all should aspire to. One last question, if that's okay?
Well, yes, but you better hurry. Look at all these people over here. They're starting to get hungry.
Where can I learn more about Lord Mahavir's preachings?
Only one place, Harimandir Pachala, where kids have summarized the 10 commandments in one lovely song.
You might want to sing it, Lord Warner, don't worry. Be happy. In every bar we have some trouble, but when you worry, make it double, don't worry. Be happy. Don't worry, be happy now. Lord Mahavir gave us teachings, just follow his preachings. Don't worry, be happy. Every soul is independent.
Every soul is alive.
Don't worry. Be happy.
Don't worry.
Be happy now. Don't worry. Be happy. Every soul is omniscient, bliss does not come from outside.
Every object is in itself, humans are miserable due to own faults. Don't worry,
be happy.
Don't worry, be happy now.
Don't worry, be happy now.
Greatest mistake is non-recognition. We need to recognize ourselves. There is no separate God's existence. You can make effort in God's direction.
Don't worry, be happy.
Don't worry, be happy now.
Don't worry, be happy now.
God is neither creator nor destructor. He is only an observer. Know yourself, immerse thyself. But you get to live again, you can be God. Don't worry,
be happy.
Don't worry, be happy now. Don't worry, be happy.
We all hope you've enjoyed it and get inspired to follow the path that afterwards by Norvira. Do it again.